Hello friends, I am Lina and today I am going to share eggless soft and fluffy ladi pav recipe. These eggless ladi pav are simple to make and taste better than store-bought one. So let's get started. Here I am taking a 3/4 cup of warm water. Make sure you use the warm water. You can also use the warm milk and add 2 teaspoon of sugar and add 2.5 teaspoon of active dry yeast. Here I am using a active dry yeast. You can also use instant yeast. If you are using a instant yeast, then you don't need to activate the yeast. You can directly add into the flour. Whisk it well and cover it and let it sit for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, the yeast will look like a thick and creamy paste. That means the yeast is active well and it's alive. If the yeast doesn't form or not activated well, then please discard the yeast and start the process again, because the flat yeast give the result dense and sticky pav. Next, here I am taking a 2.5 cup of all-purpose flour or maida. Into the flour, add 1 teaspoon of salt or as per your taste and add 2 teaspoon of milk powder. Today I am using a stand mixture for kneading the dough, but if you don't have a stand mixture, you can knead the dough using your hand. Then add the yeast mixture little at a time and knead the dough. If you are using a stand mixture, then attach the dough hook and start the process on slow speed and mix until flour is incorporated, and add the yeast mixture and knead the dough again. Add 4 to 5 tablespoons of water little at a time and knead the dough on slow to medium level and increase the speed slowly. Here you can see our dough has been started combined. It will take me around 5 to 6 minutes. Then add 2 tablespoons of room temperature butter and knead the dough again for 1 to 2 minutes. If you are kneading the dough using your hand, then knead the dough at least 12 to 15 minutes until it gets soft and unsticky. Now I am going to remove the dough from the bowl and bring it onto the countertop. So add some flour onto the countertop and knead the dough for 1 to 2 minutes. Once the dough kneaded well, grease the bowl with butter or oil and add the dough into the bowl and apply some oil onto the dough. I live in a cold weather, so I am proofing dough in my instant pot, but you can leave the bowl in any warm place for 2 hours. Just make sure you cover the bowl with plastic wrap or towel. If you are using an instant pot, then click on yogurt button and put the timer for 1 or 1.5 hour. After 1 hour, the dough will get double in size. Punch the dough and knead it slightly to remove air. Using a knife or scraper, divide the dough into equal portion and grease the baking tray with oil, or you can use baking paper, and roll the dough and make it smooth top of each of the portion like this and place it into the tray. Same way, make all the balls and cover with soft towel or plastic wrap and allow it for second rise. It will take around 30 to 45 minutes depending on the weather. After 30 to 45 minutes, the rolls will get double in size, and brush the rolls with milk and put them into preheated oven 350 Fahrenheit for 30 to 35 minutes. Remove the pav from the oven and apply some butter on top of the pav to get a shiny look, and put the wet cloth on top of the pav to make a pav softer and rest for 20 minutes. Let me show you how soft and fluffy our pavs are. Enjoy this pav with bhaji, vada pav or dabeli or any curry you like. If you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon button. Thank you for watching this video. Enjoy.